AMH is a blood test that fertility experts look at often for women who have had problems getting pregnant. Together with female age, AMH is a fairly good predictor of how women respond to fertility medications and of success rates from IVF. But what if you don't have infertility? What if you and your partner are just starting out trying to become pregnant? Does AMH predict a lower chance for success each month? What about over the course of a year? Hi, I'm fertility expert Dr. Randy Morris, M.D. I have the answers that you're looking for. Stay tuned. First, a little background. Women produce all of the eggs they will ever have in their life before they're born. Over time, the eggs degenerate, so egg numbers in women are constantly decreasing. Each egg is contained in a small cyst called a follicle. AMH is a hormone that is produced from the follicle cells. Higher AMH levels mean there are more eggs and follicles remaining in the ovaries compared to lower AMH levels. Treatments like IVF work best for women who produce many eggs with the use of fertility medications. Generally speaking, women with low AMH levels therefore have lower IVF success rates. I talk about that in this episode. Fertility treatments like Clomid with IUI don't require as many eggs to be produced. As a result, low AMH levels have, so far, not been found to help predict the chance for success for this treatment. I discuss that in this episode. If you're trying to conceive on your own, only one egg is required each month. We might suspect, therefore, that AMH would not be helpful in predicting the chance for pregnancy. In fact, a few years ago, a study followed a small group of people for a year and found that AMH levels drawn at the beginning of the year did not predict people who became pregnant. In other words, people with low AMH levels conceived just as often by the end of a year as people with normal AMH levels. The problem with that study is that it did not have a large number of participants. A smaller impact could have gotten missed. Recently, a study was performed with a much larger group. To be eligible for this study, participants must have first been tracking their cycles in a phone app. Second, they had to indicate that they were trying to conceive and reported when they started trying to conceive. Finally, they must have collected a blood sample to analyze their AMH levels no later than 3 months after they started trying to conceive. The study ran for about 5 years, and ultimately, 3,150 women were enrolled. So what did they find? They divided the patients into three groups based on their AMH level: low, normal, and high. Regardless of age, women in the low AMH group were about 25% less likely to become pregnant during the study than women in the normal group. Women in the normal group and high group did about the same. In fact, on any given month when they were trying to conceive, women with low AMH levels became pregnant less often. Both age and AMH were important for determining the chance for pregnancy. For example, if you were under age 30 and had a low AMH, about 66% would have become pregnant after 1 year. If your AMH levels were normal, this increased to 74%. If you were 38 years old and your AMH level was low, about 27% would be pregnant at 1 year, but 33% would be pregnant in the normal AMH group. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: for every age group, low AMH levels can help predict those couples who are less likely to become pregnant each month and the total amount that will be successful after a year of trying. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.